My friend Magda, like me, migrated to Australia from Hungary fleeing the Hungarian Revolution. I came to Australia by ship and found myself in a camp in Western Australia. Magda came by plane and spent time in Bonegilla in Victoria. When Magda tells me of her time at Bonegilla, she talks of the very tame native possums she fell in love with, the strange hot landscape, the terrible food, and the very primitive toilets. It was so much like my time in Northern. Magda had her own room within the large barracks. She was so happy with the little privacy it offered because she too had spent time in very crowded camps in Europe. I had to make do with blankets that separated me from the rest of the others. We often talked about the variations of mutton smothered in dripping. The smell permeated everything. I could manage the food, but she couldn't eat any of it, surviving on what she could. For all immigrants, English language skills were tested as a way to place people in employment. I was a translator, so I did not have to be tested, but it was harder for Margaret and her husband. They had some English, but not enough, so they were forced into menial work. Magda and I have been friends for many years. We know that people often criticize, even curse, camp life, but we never felt that way. It was always better than the circumstances we had left behind.